Hello my friend, and next I am planning to show you that how to replace this BMW's 300 series engines this temp sensor. And there is then this fuel line in here, and there is idea that when I am planning to take that out, there is small this plastic cap in here. And let's go to look closer. And there is really that plastic cap, that area what I am now moving. And next, when I am planning to take that hose away, I have to compress that plastic cap in totally in there in. And then this hose opens. And now I need tongs, and I press that in this way. And let's go to look that closer. Okay, and this is this my line. Now I have to only compress that in totally in this line, and in, if I compress that in both sides, then it is easier to install. Now I compress in here, and then I need some another tool in that another side that I can compress this like both sides. That way, and then okay, and now it went like this. Ooh. Now we can look that closer. Okay, and now this my plastic cap is in that position, and then I can only a little bit move that my hose, and it opens so easily. Okay, good. And then remember that normally there is gasoline going out, and that's there is good to be some cotton cloth, because there is gasoline, couple of spoons in there. Ooh. Okay, and then I take out this fuel injectors, this cover and this fuel rail. And for that job, now I need this 10 millimeter this socket, like 10 millimeter, and it fits in that hose and then that hose. And then I take my wrench and I remove these two small bolts, and there is second in that array. I remove also that. And now when I take that rail away, notice that there is fuel coming out. This bar is full of gasoline, and there is about half deci of gasoline or fuel and petrol. And that's do that job in outside, because soon we have a lot of gasoline, and use it there cotton clothes, and do not smoke, because now when I move that, and in my case, now I have already take that out and this is empty, but when I took that away, there is so much gasoline coming out in that hole. And now this fuel rail is in here free. Okay, and then I remove this fuel injector in a little bit away, and then I continue this my job, and I am planning to take that fuel intake manifold away, and it is that plastic part. And first I have to open in here two 10 millimeter sockets, and they look like they are these bolts. I am opening these bolts in here, in that position, and 10 millimeter socket. Now I take first bolt away, and there was small 10 millimeter nut, and then in that area in here we have next 10 millimeter socket. And there is this 10 millimeter in here. Good. And now this lower part is loosened, and then I have to open these big bolts in here. And now I need Now I need 11. This is interesting. 11 millimeter socket. 1-1 socket, and it fits in here, in that position in here. And then when I take this bolt out, I need a little bit longer bar. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 bolts what I have to open. And first I open that bolt. That bolt here. In that way. And there is these bolts, they are easy to remove. There was a little bit bigger bolt. And then in that next one in here, next one I open that one. And there is now nut. And then when I have removed all of these bolts, we can continue. Okay, and now all bolts are free in that hole in here, in this area, that this hole, it is free, and then this next one, it is in here, that one is free, and then next one in there, it is free, and then this one, and then this final one, it is in here, that area, and it is also free. Excellent. And now all these bolts are free, and then I can lift out that intake manifold. In that way, I lift that. And there is not so much space, and then I have to keep that lower part in position. And now this intake manifold, this is free. And these engine sensors location, they are just in below of this intake manifold. You can see that these sensors are in here, in that one. Okay, and then when I remove that temp and sensor, I need wrench what size is 22 millimeter. And then when I install this my tool in that position in here, that way, and then I rotate in here, this bolt opens. And let's look closer. Now I take this my tool in here, and then I rotate, and now this temp sensor opens. And this one is this temp sensor, because there is coolant in here, coolant coming out. Okay, good.